Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about two Pandas examples, the US housing market and the US unemployment map. We will use the housing market data from Quando. Quando is a search engine for many financial, economic, and social datasets. To download data from Quando, you need to create a free account. Manually download the dataset Freddie Mac House Price Index New York as an Excel file from this link. This is the downloaded file's name. Put this file in the same folder as the current Jupyter Notebook file. The Freddie Mac House Price Index provides a measure of typical price inflation for houses within the United States. Values are calculated monthly by state, starting from January 1975. Let's read the worksheet 1 of the downloaded Excel file using the column date as the index. We assign the data to a date frame named df. This is the data. In September 2017, the index is 178.80. In January 1975, the index is 23.66. Note that df is in descending order right now, from 2017 to 1975. We want to sort it in ascending order by date. This is a new data frame, df. After that, we plot this data frame and show the figure on the screen. From this figure, we can see a very clear increasing trend. House prices in the New York State have increased about 7 or 8 times over the period of 42 years. Now let's try to retrieve the New York House Price Index data from the Quando website automatically. To do this, we need to install the Quando package by executing the following command in the command window or terminal. Conda install Quando. Note that this is not done within the Python environment. After the installation is done, we import Quando and then use Quando.get function to get the Freddie Mac House Price Index in New York State. Automatically retrieved data is already sorted in ascending order. Now let's retrieve the data of 4 states, California, Illinois, New York, and Texas, from the Quando website automatically. You can change this to include other states you are interested in. Note that if you don't have a Quando API key, you may see an error. It says, error downloading, too many requests. To apply for a free API key, you need to log into your Quando account. In your account settings, you will find your API key. You can also request a new API key. The first line of this program is to specify the API key. This is my old API key. You must replace this with your own API key. Otherwise, this program won't work. Here we define a list of states we are interested in. We must use the 2-letter abbreviations of the states. Next, we create an empty data frame. For each state abbreviation in this list, we concatenate it using this string to form the data label. We print out this data label to keep track of which state we are processing. Next, we use the Quando.get to retrieve the Freddie Mac House Price Index for that state. The authentication token is just the API key we defined at the beginning of this program. The next 4 lines of code will just append this state's House Price Index to the data frame df as a separate column. Finally, we set the column names to be the state abbreviations. Print the data frame df and save it to sheet 1 of the Excel file. This is the output. We processed the 4 states' house price indexes. These indexes are shown in this data frame df. Next, let's plot this data frame. Put the legend at the best location with minimum overlapping. In this figure, the California index is denoted by the blue curve, Illinois by orange, New York by green, and Texas by red. They all seem to follow the same trend, although the California curve shows much more variation than the others. We find in this figure that all these curves intersect at this point around year 2000. It turns out the Freddie Mac House Price Index is calculated so that the index value of December 2000 equals 100% for every state. Therefore, this is the reference point. December 2000 is considered the base month. We want to move the reference point to the beginning, that is, January 1975. So we use the entire date frame DF minus the zeroth row of each state and divide it by the zeroth row. We plot the new date frame. This figure shows that California house prices have increased about 13 times since January 1975. Illinois house prices have increased about 4 times during the same period. We can also calculate the correlation values of the indexes. Our correlation value is always between negative 1 and positive 1. Correlation characterizes whether two curves have a similar trend. Positive 1 means if one index increases, the other index also increases by the same amount. Negative 1 means if one index increases, the other index decreases by the same amount. In this correlation table, we see that there is a strong correlation between all these indexes. For example, the correlation between California and New York is about 0.96. It doesn't mean the increase of California house prices caused the increase of New York house prices. It just shows that they have a very similar trend. There are many more free datasets on condos.com for you to explore, like currencies, interest rates, mutual funds, real estate, energy, and metals. These are the data of many countries in the world, US, China, Europe, and so on. In this second example, we want to make a choropleth map of the US unemployment rate by county in 2009. This is the year immediately following the 2007-2008 financial crisis. A choropleth map is a way to display statistical variables on a map. It visualizes how unemployment varies across a geographic area. The unemployment data are stored in an Excel file, unemployment2009.xslx. This is the content of the Excel file. The Federal Information Processing Standard Code, or FIPS code, uniquely identifies counties and county equivalents. For example, the FIPS code for Baldwin County, Alabama, is 1003. The unemployment rate is 9.1%. The base map is stored in this file, uscounties.svg. This program uses Beautiful Soup, a Python package, to parsing XML labels in the basemap SVG file. This package is able to extract the data from HTML and XML files, which is very useful for web scraping. This program is unemployment.py. I will not explain the code in detail. I will leave it to you for practice. We can run this program in Jupyter using the run magic. This is the output. In this map, high employment rates are marked by dark blue. The US was going through a tough time in 2009 following the global financial crisis. Two out of the big three went bankrupt. Chrysler filed for bankruptcy in April 2009, and General Motors filed for bankruptcy in June 2009. California, Oregon, Michigan, and other Midwestern and Southeastern states suffered a lot. The Northeastern states, the Mountain states, and the South Central states were not so bad. I just talked about two Pandas examples in this video. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.